Welcome to The Sound, and it's a hot one in Oregon. We're having a three-day heat wave. And experiencing the heat wave with me, both of us part of the have-not class, and I'm referring to air conditioning, Evelyn Holland. That's right. Evelyn is a singer, songwriter, and guitar player, and a big, giant Opeth fan, as you can see from her shirt. Yes.
Yeah.
What's new with you?
I actually played a gig at a coffee shop Saturday. It was my first gig. I like actual gig in a couple of years, and it's more like an audition, but I was talking with the promoters. There's two of them. One's like more on the like the he was like recording everything and taking pictures, and I apparently, from what the other guy told me, he's gonna build us a website or something like that. But he's part of, Propulsion Networks or something like that. Both of them are. It's like a promotion company, and they're connected with a bunch of venues. I'm not sure.
Cool. Well, below me, we have Kyle Walls. Kyle's a singer, songwriter, and a guitar player. What have you been doing?
Yeah, on my channel, I just started a new series of videos called City Music Stories. And actually, after this first one, and I had to do my hometown, St. Louis, where I am.
Oh, yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, I did. I have Chuck Berry and Nelly. So after that first one, I had the second one already slotted, but the comments from the first one, someone commented Chicago, and someone commented the Thielman Brothers, which we reacted to, and I didn't know that they were actually from The Hague and the Netherlands. So I have those videos coming up.
We also have one more special guest introduced today. Of course, I could never, ever forget Jennifer Valiquette, music teacher, saxophone player, and flute player. Jennifer, you know, we're going to be doing more work on that Miley project, but what else are you doing?
Yeah. Well, I just put up Jar of Hearts, actually, on my page. I did a cover yesterday, Jar of Hearts, and I ended up improvising a little bit in the middle of the song, so that was kind of fun. So I just did it on saxophone. But yeah, mostly for singing, I'm working on the Miley thing, which I've never really sang in public before, so it's going to have to be like, you know, I'm going to have to perfect it, but...
Your voice is not an instrument. Yeah, you use your voice as an instrument, but it's not like a well-tempered thing when you get started, like a piano or a guitar or whatever other instrument. Mm-hmm. It's going to vary, and you just have to embrace that. And then after some muscle memory practice, it's not an issue anymore. And that couldn't have been more
accurate. Wow, I like that.
Because the idea, because I was trying to use my voice like a guitar, and I was so frustrated.
Yeah, it gets frustrating because, like, when you're so used to hearing things in tune, and then when you sing out of tune, it's like, nope, nope.
Yeah.
Like, that's how I am with my singing. Matthew's got the cooling pad over there.
Ice pack down my shirt.
Oh, I feel so bad.
I got personal air conditioning unit installed. Oh, whew. If I lean back against the chair, my back gets all cold. I like it. Oh, I said I got a bag of tricks here. In here, I have additional ice water. I have a frosty mug. And if necessary, I have a Scottish ale to cool me off.
Yeah.
And then I got four of these therapy gel packs. And of course, to start off, gotta have the cold brew. Get some high brew. Ba-da-doop, doop, doop, boop. High brew. Boop, boop, doop, boop.
Well, I think we reacted to what Gates of Babylon in the past. This is actually from they have a new singer now. What's his name? Donnie. I forget his name, but I think they found him from, yeah, it was Lord of Black in Brazil, I want to say, or something like that. It's kind of an obscure Rainbow album, and Error of Rainbow, Stranger in Us All. I the bit or anything like that. I love it. I'd love to get the album on vinyl, but they did a I think a 2-year tour for this record, and I mean they did a lot of the stuff from the record and a lot of the Dio and Joe Lynn Turner era classics on that tour, and I kind of like Dewey White's vocals. I know nowadays he kind of has this whole thing, and he has a couple of bands. I think one of them is Demon's Eye. I forget the others, but yeah. Anyways, definitely check out his stuff if you get a chance.
Right on. Let's go ahead and get this going here. So without further ado, Musicians Panel reacts to Rainbow Ariel live at Philipp Schall Dusseldorf, 1995 HD. Here we go!
In your dreams, in your nightmares, in your every waking moment, she is Ariel.
Yeah.
I can't sleep tonight. Just leave me alone. Leave me, leave me, leave me, leave me.
Okay, I got a lot to say about this. Man, I love Ritchie Blackmore's solo at the beginning. I thought that was so smooth. I felt like that was, it was up in line with the greats. I mean, it was as pretty as a Leap's intro to Hotel California, the special version from the Hell Freezes Over tour. Mm-hmm. It was, you know, okay. And I really liked that riff. It felt like Kashmir almost. Now I'm not saying they copied. It just felt like it had like a Led Zeppelin-y influence vibe, although it was a completely original song. Freaking kicked ass. The vocals almost sounded Robert Plant-ish. Now I'm not, I don't know, I haven't heard that singer before that I know of, so I'm not trying to claim lordship over singing, but I felt like that whole song, it was like Pink Floyd / Led Zeppelin influenced, along with, of course, you know, that whole, you know, Deep Purple, Ritchie Blackmore, of course, thing. I loved his guitar solo where he was playing with the volume knob. When we did our recent reaction to Rush, I got ripped apart because I said that Alex Lyson was playing with his volume knob when, in fact, he was playing with a volume pedal with his foot. It's the same thing! It sounds the same. I couldn't tell which appendage he was using. Shame on me. Shame on me for not knowing which appendage Alex Lifeson was using to create an effect that could be done with the hand or with the foot, okay? I don't know crap. Anyway, but I love that part where Ritchie Blackmore was playing with the volume knob. It was so soulful. And the one negative point I want to say, and this is as a guitar player, I do this, so this is... Ritchie was rushing. Did you notice?
Yeah.
He was rushing just a little bit. And the drummer was like, just like Kashmir. The drummer was like, no, And I think that's why Ritchie, I don't know who the drummer was, but they were awesome. I think that's why Ritchie loved him, because he kept him in check. The drummer would not let Ritchie rush. So those little tiny moments where he was rushing, you could feel, then Ritchie would hold back just a tiny, tiny bit, like you do when you're playing live, in order to resync 100% with the drummer. And that kind of gave it a little bit of a tug of war, push pull kind of feel that was just really interesting to watch. Because as a solo artist, I'll tell you my biggest mistake is when I rush. I'll tell you, I'll give away my secrets. I did Europa, acoustic version, with just acoustic guitar loop, and then tenor saxophone for the melody. Where I messed up was when I was making the loop. I accidentally gradually sped up as I made this ridiculous 36-bar loop. because there's so many changes in that song. You have to go through the eight bars four times to get all the, because there's only one chord that's different, but it's on the third time out of four. So you got to play the whole 32 bars in order to get that one little major seventh chord instead of a minor chord, right? That one borrowed chord. Anyway, so I'm going, getting faster and faster as I'm playing this, and then I go to play my saxophone and I hit the loop, and it's like slowed down like a ton, like all at once. And I was like, "Oh crap!" And of course, I kept going, but I was like, "Man, this is going to be awkward every time it repeats," you know. So we were talking about the, you know, the Rainbow performance, and it was just, I felt it was really awesome. I really enjoyed the guitar, especially at the beginning. And we were talking about the push and pull tug of war that was kind of going on with Richie and the drummer, because Richie was just rushing just a little bit. Yeah. And it was really interesting to see the drummer just holding back. And I'm the only one who talked, and I was saying that I felt like there was a lot of Led Zeppelin influence. I felt like there was a lot of Kashmir influence in that song. Really cool riffs, and I just really enjoyed watching the tug of war that was going on between Richie and the drummer, because the drummer was just like, we going this speed. No, bitch, you go this speed. And I just saw the respect in Richie's eyes, because, like, I think that's why he loved that drummer. It was because he, like, kept him in check the whole time.
Rainbow and Richie Blackmore always make me think of my middle brother, who's 14 years older than I am. He got me started playing guitar and stuff. And when I hear that music, I think of, you know, my brother. I think about playing guitar, being completely fascinated. You know, my brother would play music like that way past my bedtime, you know, because he was older. And I just lay awake in bed listening to him play, music. And it was just so much fuel for my imagination, you know, growing up. And what's funny is I hear stuff like that now, and it's going to be awful. I really don't like music like that. I don't know why. It just, I appreciate it. It's cool. And maybe it's because growing up, it wasn't until I was like 10 or so that I realized, oh, there's other music besides what my brothers play. You know, I don't know what it was, but I hear something like this. Like, it's cool, but I'm like, oh man, I wish there was something else to it. But anyway, that's a me thing. Focusing more on the song, you mentioned the Kashmir quality. I was thinking it might be, and this was kind of, Rainbow and Deep Purple, their trademark, having the synthesizer go along with the guitar, because that just makes such a fat musical spectrum, you know? Mm-hmm. And the way the Kashmir kind of has this kind of droning aspect, even though it's not a drone note, but, you know, it just repeats that same riff over and over. This Rainbow song really achieved that. And trying to figure it out, you know, it seems that talking about a person, Ariel, of dreams and nightmares, you can imagine that relationship didn't go very well, if that's what the song was about. But, you know, you get that basic idea. So that idea that this complex, repetitious groove really goes along with that message, you know, and that was pretty cool from a songwriting aspect.
Right.
Right on. That's so cool, man. I mean, you know, just maybe you're not like particularly into a particular song, but you can still see the value in it. Mm-hmm. And I see that a lot of times, you know, on here. I have broadened my horizons so much from doing this show, and I'm not going to stop, because it's so much fun and excellent. And like, I feel like as a performer, I'm going by leaps and bounds by listening to all these other performers that you guys like. And just, if I can absorb, you know, one little tenth of a percent every time I listen to something, you know what I mean? That just adds up so fast, especially doing this 2 days a week.
I was just going to say, I thought it was cool. Not the style of music that I usually listen to, but I liked it. And like you guys said, he definitely had some relationship issues in that song, I think. Mm-hmm. And, of course, the minute I thought of Ariel, I was thinking of The Little Mermaid, because that's who I am. But, you know.
Remember, everybody, go to all of our YouTube channels, smash up the like button on this video, subscribe to Jennifer's music page, subscribe to Kyle Wall, subscribe to Evelyn Holland. Kyle's pushing towards 10,000, and Eve is pushing towards 1,000. We really need your help. This is a big channel drive. If you support Matthew's Music Lesson Studio, please support the rest of the channels in the network. We really appreciate you guys. Thank you so much, everybody, and share this out so lots of people can see it. You can get bonus content from me on Patreon. I'm doing 4 videos a month now on Patreon. I got some lost time to make up for. So 1 video every week, bonus on Patreon. Patreon.com/Matthew's Music Lesson Studio. Go over there now, sign up. Please also, Matthew's Music Lesson Studio.com. Thank you so much, and we'll see you next time on The Sound Live! Thank you guys so much.